Xong trình cười. Xong trình lúc mình thử vi nôn chía là mà to xong nùa.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Mr.
Civil Party, we just established that Chim was the prison chief of Khmer. Let me read to you what you said in relation to Chim in respect of his arrest. It is again your DCTM statement, EPS-5643. English ERN 00735839 French 0075664846. This is what you said. I arrested A Chim, the contemptible Chim. Question, what did he do wrong? He made up confessions. He just wrote this person was connected to this person. But after investigations, we found that he had arrested many people. So he was arrested. Well, he cried. And I said, that is your sin. He thought I was kidding. I told him, be still. I did not yet take out the gun. There were two of us. You stay still. I tie you up. I told him. Well, how will you tie me? He asked. And I responded, I'm serious. I'm tying you up. He said, no. He did not let me tie him up,
but I kept the gun.
He asked why I was doing that. I said it was not up to his fate. We put him on the truck. He began crying out loud. He was brought to Kotom.
Mr.
Civil Party, you recall telling this to the DCK investigator?
Nhóm phạm bình ta là ngay đường anh nè ông thoát hết bởi lư nè chùm láo gì hồi kỳ ngọc đi xa cho cô ở đây anh đang thấy vui anh cho màn dây mẹ khóc vì nâng nhầm được ọt lần này thì bà
How long after you witnessed the execution of 10 people was Chim arrested by you? How long after the events of the execution? That I understand, because you said he was in charge of Khmer prison at the time of this execution of 10 people. But my question was, how long was it after the execution that you arrested Chim?
ពីខែទេប្រហែលជា đọc thằng ngày ấy đó nhiều ta mà trong bữa đây đi và hiểu bởi sao vậy mình chăm mình pê pê lia đi còn là còn đang thả dạ pê lấy mình ngay còn mà tệ vì nhầm từ khơi cái thằng láp hơi cái đôi mó à bình thiên có cồn từ còn phân oi hay là hay nhóm chặt tròn vía đã làn từ có thông từ này.
Now, are you in a position to tell us whether his arrest was somehow connected to the execution of 10 people? In other words, was he arrested because of his involvement in the execution of those 10 people?
เนี่ยสําหรับในนี้คือเรื่องที่กับสังเกตเสียงได้ไล่แต่ตามคําดังอาชีพเวียประเทศกุกนั้นเรื่องเสียงคือว่าเป็นเลือดสําลายเรื่องอาจมีเรื่องจะตินงานที่ดอบเนี่ยไผเนี่ยไอ้เสียงๆนี่ก็ก่อนนั่นเอง
Now another question I have is, how was it that you were in the position to tell that those 10 people that you saw being executed were in fact
ອາຍຈະຫຼາຍທ່ານແນ່ໄດ້ເກສໍາລັບແຕ່ດອກແນ່ໄດ້ຕົບານເກສໍາລັບແຕ່ດອກເພິ່ນຄືຈະຈຸນຈິດຈັນດິຈິນໍຕາລົກສະກໍຊມຸຂອງພວກເກເຕຕາລົກດັງທ່າແນ່ຕ້ອງດອກແນ່ນຸຫມອກໄປຄຸມນາໄດ້ຕາລົກດັງດອກລະບຽບນາຍົມອັດບານດັງນິໄຍທ່າມອງຈິດຈຸນຈິດໃຫ້ ແລະនៅខុំណាខ្ញុំអត់ដឹងទេឃើញតែគេជូនមកដាក់កន្លែងគេសំដៅសំឡាប់ហ្នឹងព្រោះតែពេលហ្នឹងវាចាមក៏ដូចជាយួនដូចជាចិនហ្នឹងវាងាយខ្មែរស្វះចេះហើយនាមមកជាជំនិតអីជំនិតអីប្រកបជាទេខ្ញុំគាត់ដឹងគាត់ឃើញមិនងាយហោនេះផងលួចទៅមើលគេទេអានឹងខ្ញុំឃើញប៉ុណ្្នឹង
But why is it then that you said to DCCAM and repeated that here yesterday that these 10 people were quote-unquote Chinese and Vietnamese expatriates?
Why did you say that if you didn't know?
ខ្ញុំ អត់ បាន និយាយ រឿង ទេ ព្រោះ ពេល នោះ ខ្ញុំ ឃើញ ពេល គេ ត្រូវ សម្លាប់ ដែល ខ្ញុំ ទៅ ឈរ មើល នឹង វា អត់ ឃើញ មាន ចិន ឯ ក៏ យួន ឯ ណា ផង ទេ មិន នឹង ជា ជន ជាតិ ឯ ប្រកាស ប្រជា ទេ គាត់ នៅ ទៅ ឈរ មើល នឹង អត់ ហ៊ាន អះអាល ជាមួយ អង្គការ ណា ក៏ ខ្ញុំ មិន បាន និយាយ ដែរ រឿង របស់ ខ្ញុំ
Mr. Civil Party, I'm going to ask you a question now. And that sounds a bit peculiar what I'm going to say now. But since both this court and the legal lawyers for the Civil Party have neglected apparently advising you that you have a right not to incriminate yourself. I will do so for you. So, but I'm about to ask you, you don't have to answer. Were you involved yourself in the execution of those 10 people somehow? For instance, did you make a list
ទេអូទេដូចជាលោកជាអ្នករៀបចំបញ្ជីឈ្មោះដែលក្រោយមកលោកក៏បានបញ្ជូនបញ្ជីឈ្មោះនេះទៅឲ្យគណៈកម្មាធិការស្រុកតើលោកមានចូលរួមពាក់ព័ន្ធក្នុងការសម្លាប់មនុស្សទាំង 10នាក់នេះទេ
Merci. Merci, Monsieur le Président. Juste une observation qui appartiendra à la Chambre de savoir si la question peut être posée ou non. Comment notre confrère peut-il savoir ce que nous disons, ce que nous discutons avec la partie civile, donc qu'il arrête de faire des conjectures sur ce qui se passe lorsqu'on rencontre nos clients. Nous ne faisons aucune conjecture quand lui rencontre nos clients. Donc ce commentaire est particulièrement déplacé. Qu'il s'occupe de son client, et nous nous occupons des nôtres.
Fine, let me shift my surprise not to the civil party lawyers but to the chamber. I observe that every person that might incriminate himself, even if it's the lowest cadre, is accompanied by a standby counsel. And I'm just wondering why this particular civil party has been such counsel. So that's the reason I'm advising him that he doesn't have the answer to answer the question. But the question is still relevant whether he himself is somehow involved in the execution of those 10 people.
Your Honor, these comments by counsel are highly improper. It's not for him to be advising this witness of civil party. If the civil party wanted counsel, he certainly has counsel here to consult this is a transparent effort to try to intimidate. He should ask his questions and he should stop playing games in this courtroom by trying to intimidate individuals who are here.
Fine, then please answer my question, Mr. Civil Party. Were you yourself involved in the execution of those 10 people? Did you make the list?
Did
you have a role to play in the execution of those 10 people?
ហើយការអីទេបញ្ជីឈ្មោះដែលគេធ្វើតាមឃុំមកគេឲ្យខ្ញុំមកទុកມັນទាំងមើលទេខ្ញុំគាត់តែប៉ុណ្្នឹងទេឯដល់ពេលនោះខ្ញុំនឹកឃើញក៏ទៅលេងមើលចង់ដឹងតើគេធ្វើសម្លាប់វាម៉េចបានបាញ់សម្លាប់វាណាបានខ្ញុំមិនដឹងហ្នឹងបានឃើញគេពេលហ្នឹងម្ដង
អត់មានតែហ៊ានជិតទីគាត់ឲ្យគេហ៊ានជា10ម៉ែត្រថាណល់ទេហើយ8-9ម៉ែត្រពីទីទៅសម្លាប់នឹងបានតែប៉ុណ្្នឹងទេខ្ញុំក៏ត្រឡប់មកកន្លែងមក
But with all due respect, Mr. Civil Party, you were not just someone who was peeping through the bushes or through a crack in the wall. You were the one that arrested the person responsible 10 days later. So you are just an innocent bystander,
correct? Sorry, Councillor, you drew a conclusion. Innocent bystander.
Please give me a break, Judge Fens.
Questions. We'll allow you to ask questions, as you have said. We draw the conclusions. We are in the same trial as you are.
Mr. Civil Party, were you not involved in the execution since you have the power to arrest the person who is responsible?
Ta lok mun chol ruom pek pon krong ka samlap lok teang 10 neak ni tae tae ru no pel dae lok ko trob ban ke banchie oy chap me khlong ne ni
ខ្ញុំ មិន នឹង ឆ្លើយ ថា ម៉េច ទៀត ទេ នេះ ខ្ញុំ ពេល នេះ ខ្ញុំ ទៅ ឈរ មើល គេ ទេ ខ្ញុំ មិន មែន ទៅ ចូល រួម ចាត់ ចែង អា នេះ ទៅ បាញ់ អា នេះ ទៅ អី ណា នេះ ទេ អត់ ទេ ពាក្យ ថា ចូល រួម គឺ អ្នក ជួយ បាញ់ គ្នា អី ដែរ ហើយ ខ្ញុំ គាត់ ទៅ ឈរ មើល ខ្ញុំ ថា ចង់ ដឹង ដោយ បាន ជំរាប លោក មេ ធាវី
No problem, Mr. Civil Party. Let me move on to another subject. That is the alleged killing, or the alleged policy of killing, rather, former Khmer Republic officials. You said yesterday, and also in your WRI, officials from the former regime would not be spared and they needed to be smashed. You said that this is something that you had learned at my question to you is, when was it that you heard this during study session? What year?
អរគុណជំនួសនេះខ្ញុំសូមឆ្លើយថាដូចហួសពេលហើយខ្ញុំឡើយសូមបញ្ជាក់តោះពីនោះមកដល់ឥឡូវគិតទៅតាមដែលខ្ញុំដឹងរៀនសូត្រហ្នឹងចិត្តឆ្នាំទី
I understand Mrs. Hilpati, it's a long time ago, but it is quite important that you somehow tell us when it was. Because if it was before 1975, then killing of Khmer Republic soldiers would be legitimate because there was a war going on. So my question is, did you hear that officials from, or soldiers from the former regime would not be spared before 17 April 75? Or after
1975?
Fine. And now my question is, which year was it? Was it in 75, directly after liberation, or was it many years later, or a few years later?
ដង តាម ការវគ្គ នយោបាយ អានោះ អង្គភាព ខ្ញុំ កង វរៈសេនា តូច របស់ ខេត្ត តកែង កន្លែង ដែល ខ្ញុំ នៅ ទៅ មកជា អង្គភាព ខ្ញុំ គឺ បើក វគ្គ រៀន សូត្រ រឿង ដឹង ថា ទៅ បោស សម្អាត អី ខ្ញុំ ដឹង ប៉ុណ្ណឹង បាទ
Well, you were a Southwest Song Cadre Civil Party, so it's important that we get the chronology straight.
để nhóm trâu tại su ông pi cao và bọn này ông ban mà lo tam nằm nổi ta về pi bị khai cầu cho nam một bộ đội chất sập ram rư co phần màn khai cầu cho nam một bộ đội chất sập ram rư co phần màn cho nam cầu một bộ đội chất sập ram để lục ban liên số pi cô vô bài này
cả nên khi em liên số nơi ông gặp hiệp tốt là nhầm rồi nữ với bị còi nắng khi nhầm bị cà tử đăng thầm năng thì lên đăng thế về liệu chưa đã
If I have time, I will get back to the chronology. Who was it
that said
that officials from the former regime, including soldiers
and officers, said that? អតីតអ្នករដ្ឋការរបបលន់នល់នឹងគឺថាមិនទុកជីវិតឲ្យរស់ទេអ្នកណាអ្នកនិយាយរឿងនេះ
ពេលនោះគេហៅថាវគ្គមិនមែនជាសាលាទេវគ្គគឺបានតែ3ថ្ងៃទេហើយសាលាដល់ពី7ទៅ10ថ្ងៃហើយខ្ញុំគឺបើកវគ្គយោបាយខ្លីៗដើម្បីអប់រំអ្នកដឹកនាំបន្តបន្តមកពីរឿងគោលនយោបាយរបស់បកកុម្មុយនីសកម្ពុជាគឺអង្គភាពខ្ញុំគេមានតួនាទីគ្រប់គ្រងបើកវគ្គនយោបាយឈ្មោះបាវគឺអ្នកជាអង្គភាពវិជាការស្នងការរដ្ឋាភិបាលរបស់ខ្ញុំហ្នឹង
My question was, who was it? Was it your battalion commander who said this about former officials and soldiers? And if yes, what was his name?
ឲ្យកម្មាភិបាលខាងក្រោមហើយខ្ញុំបានជំរាបហើយថាអ្នកបើកវគ្គអប់រំរៀនសូត្រពួកខ្ញុំពេលនោះគឺវិជាការកងរដ្ឋការតូចរបស់ខ្ញុំឈ្មោះបាវ
From whom
maybe
if you know
person ជាលោកដឹង
តើ in relation to
បាវបានទទួលការណែនាំនេះមកពីខាងណាដែរតកតងទៅនឹងជោគវាសនាន
ៃអតីត for himself or whether he was acting upon the instruction
តើលោកធ្វើនេះធ្វើតាមបញ្ញាធ្វើតាមបញ្ជារបស់បាវនេះឬក៏យ៉ាងណាន
ឹងពាក្យថាខ្ញុំលែងដឹងត្រឹមនឹងហើយព្រោះខ្ញុំក្រមការអប់រំរបស់បាវហើយក្រមពីបាវទៅពេលនេះគាត់ដឹងថាគណៈនិមន្តនឹងពីណាទីខ្ញុំដូចថាចប់ទៅនឹងដែរ
Well, it's important to understand whether
we may say that's important enough in order to
explain your bond was speaking for himself because we have quite some testimony in this courtroom from testimony from district cadres such as Bechim, Sawan, who all say that specifically in the southwest there was a policy not to touchSoldiers all the way up until the rank of colonel. Is that something that you heard? Is that something that you heard? Is that something that you heard? Is that something that you heard?
ចាប់ពីសក្តាមចុះមកនោះទេលោកមានលឺអំពីបញ្ហានេះទេ
តាមរងរដ្ឋបាលនេះមិនអាចឆ្លើយសូមជួយលោកប្រញ្ញា
Yes, I object to the way counsel has phrased his question. He's represented to the witness that everybody has said this. There are two out of about 100 witnesses who have said this. The others have said the opposite. So he can confront them with their testimony, but he shouldn't be representing to him that this is what everybody says.
I'm not sure if I said everybody, but if I did, I'll withdraw that. There is no need now, specifically because we all heard that testimony, to read out the exact quotes from those people.
Mr. President, I disagree. The practice here is if he wants to confront with evidence, he should use it. He shouldn't be characterizing because he's mischaracterizing evidence, and I'm not going to get any detail because he's using some names. He should be using documents and following the court practice here.
Yes, as per practice, if you confront him with testimony, obviously you have to give the references.
Mr.
Where was it that this palm, this battalion commander, talked about the officials of the former regime? Where was it? Well, you don't remember where it was that you heard this. I understand that it was in your battalion. Where were you? Where was your battalion physically when you heard this? But at least you should be able to tell us the district, the sector where you were.
where
the battalion was?
ពីថ្ងៃខ្ញុំគុយនឹកហ្នឹងដល់ថ្ងៃនៅស្រុកកោះអណ្ដែតកន្លែងពួកខ្ញុំជិតព្រំដែនខ្មែរយួនស្រុកកោះអណ្ដែត
Let me move on. I only have a few more minutes.
Mình tại vì khi ông mình to từ một tiết cho đến xa khi ông nó sol về đại bảy buồn để tì tiệt tê lâu mà đào mình đang ngồi tập bài về ní.
Something you said in your WRI.
Nên cứ giờ bây này lục lại cứ ở bảy là buồn sôi tổng buồn. Sầm nuôi chậm lại lấy sai sập buồn không có loạn hay sập chậm lại được bỏ lố.
You're talking about the principle that lone soldiers had to be smashed. But in that same answer, you said the people were classified in two categories, the new people and the base people. And then you say, quote-unquote, the new people had to be smashed, end of quote. Did you say that?
There
was no such there was no policy to smash new people, correct?
Không đối chứ mình ban thì cái gì chứ riêng hàng hiện chẳng rồi pi đậm pi mê xa tới xa lên đập bàn riêng ấy cái tết nhưng đối ban tìm hiểu á lại chỉ được chuyên cái ca bỏ kiệt tật đầy tới chọc vào tâm nó riêng nữa.
One last subject returning to the Chinese origin.
Nhóm còn đăng này còn lưu cái thẩm lạp mà xa đó để ở trong xu ở trong ta hai ấy đăng ấy nhưng mình đăng có cái nè mình chia cái nè kì nà này to to mấy cái nhóm chọn trẻ đăng ấy thành cả bọc bạc của mình nó nhóm lần đó còn này.
I understand.
Let's
move away from the execution of those 10 people.
ប្រាំប្រាំប្រាំខ្មែរសូនសូនសូនប្រាំប្រាំបួនបីប្រាំសូនបារាំងសូនសូនប្រាំពីរណៃនសិកប្រាំបួនប្រាំមួយប្រាំប្រាំបួនប្រាំបីលោកបាននិយាយថាសំដកស្រង់គឺមានផែនការកំទេចជនជាតិចិននិងជនជាតិវៀតណាមតើហេតុអ្វីក៏មានផែនការកំទេចជនជាតិចិននិងជនជាតិវៀតណាមទីពាក្យនេះដូចខ្ញុំឆ្លើយថាខ្ញុំអត់ដឹងផងហើយខ្ញុំខ្លាចថាម៉េច
So you didn't know about a plan.
ចឹងលោកមិនដឹងពីផែនការដើម្បីកំទេចជនជាតិចិនទេហើយខ្ញុំយល់ថាលោកក៏មិនដឹងពីផែនការដើម្បីសម្លាប់ជនជាតិវៀតណាមដែរតើអញ្ចឹងឬយ៉ាងម៉េចបាទតើរដ្ឋបាលមិនអត់ទាន់ឆ្លើយសូមជួយលោកប្រញ្ញា
That's not what the witness just testified. He was asked about the reason, not whether there was a plan. He was asked what the reason was for killing.
And he said he didn't know the reason why. He included in the Chinese.
Fine, no problem. I'll adjust.
Mithavi, but I have a question.
Ms. Silverbody, just to make sure that I understand properly, you don't know what the reason was about potentially smashing ethnic Chinese, but just to make sure, was there a policy to kill Chinese people?
Je peux répondre, Monsieur le Président.
J'ai
indiqué à mon confrère que j'avais besoin de 15 à 20 minutes pour interroger la partie civile. Nous devrions terminer avant la pause déjeuner.
One last thing before I hand over the floor to my colleague. So there was no such slogan.
I'm not entirely sure if that's correct, but I'll finish my question. Thank you, Mr. President.
Je vous remercie, Monsieur le Président. Bonjour à tous. Que vous avez dit hier, et c'était un petit peu après 9h55 et 52 secondes, vous avez dit ceci, je vous cite, la question qui vous était posée était de savoir comment vous organisiez les mariages, et vous dites, je suivais simplement l'ordre donné par le chef de district qui voulait que je procède ainsi. Je devais recueillir les biographies des unités itinérantes, des hommes et des femmes, puis décider qui devait épouser qui. Je suivais simplement l'instruction du comité de district. Ce n'était pas ma propre décision. Fin de citation. La première question à ce sujet est de savoir est-ce que vous étiez en charge d'organiser simplement les mariages entre les gens des unités itinérantes et des unités des femmes, ou est-ce que vous occupiez également des mariages au niveau des communes et des villages ?
ការងារពីលេខាស្រុកកងចល័តដែលត្រូវមានអាយុ
Ma question n'était peut-être pas très claire. J'ai compris ce point. Ma question est de savoir est-ce que vous occupiez uniquement des mariages dans les unités itinérantes ou est-ce que vous aviez des prérogatives également au sein des coopératives et des communes ?
Donc, si je comprends bien, au niveau des communes, et ça, je vais vous relire ce que vous avez indiqué, c'était le 29 août vers 11h13, vous avez indiqué que c'était les chefs de communes qui devaient se charger d'organiser les mariages dans leurs coopératives et dans les coopératives de leurs communes. Est-ce que j'ai bien compris que, à ce niveau-là, c'était les chefs de communes qui étaient responsables d'organiser les mariages et que vous, en tant que comité de district, vous n'interveniez pas? Est-ce que j'ai bien compris?
Je voudrais
Je vous demande ces précisions parce que nous avons entendu un responsable, un chef de district du district de Barai, Tepok. C'était à l'audience du 22 août dernier. Et lui, il indiquait ceci en ce qui concerne le rôle du comité de district sur les mariages, en disant que c'était un petit peu avant, donc 15h16 et 42 secondes, en disant que le chef de coopérative venait au district présenter la proposition et ensuite c'est le district qui tranchait, que la décision était rendue par écrit. Fin de citation. Donc ma question est de savoir, est-ce que en ce qui concerne votre district de Soeun, est-ce que les chefs de communes, le responsable de coopérative, venait avec des propositions que vous deviez entériner par la suite, ou est-ce que vous n'aviez pas du tout de droit de regard sur ce qui se passait sur les communes et les villages.
គល់ឲ្យតាមឃុំមួយមួយអើចឹងឃុំមួយមួយត្រូវជ្រើសរើសនឹងរៀបការឲ្យយុវជនជនរីរបស់ឃុំយើងតាមឃុំយើងខ្លួនបើឯងនៅស្រុកជុំវិញរបស់កាលារស់ហ្នឹងគឺខែមានច្រើនគឺមានកងច្រឡាត់អញ្ចឹងវាមានខាងប្រុសនិងខាងស្រី
Ok, donc je comprends de votre réponse que les communes étaient indépendantes et faisaient, organisaient les mariages comme elles l'entendaient au niveau de leur commune et de leur coopérative. Donc je vais maintenant m'intéresser plus particulièrement au processus qui se passait au niveau du district. Vous avez indiqué que c'est vous qui, depuis votre bureau de chef adjoint du comité de district regardait les listes et arrangeait les mariages. Ma question est de savoir, est-ce que lorsqu'on vous donnait ces listes, vous aviez des demandes qui avaient été formulées par les chefs des unités mobiles. Est-ce que, en vous donnant une liste, ils vous disaient telle personne a demandé à pouvoir se marier avec telle personne, etc. Et est-ce que vous teniez compte de ces demandes si elles vous étaient présentées?
ទាំងពីរផ្នែកចលាត់ខាងនារីខាងបុរសហ្នឹងតាមផែនការគណៈស្រុកថាឲ្យជ្រើសរើសសារហ្នឹងយកប្រហែលថា 20 ឬ 30 គូប្រកាសហ្នឹងហើយឥឡូវយកបាន 25 សារហ្នឹង 25 គូអញ្ចឹងកងចលាត់ទាំងសងខាងហ្នឹងគេយកចំនួនរៀងខ្លួន ប្រាប់មកឲ្យបងប្អូនអញ្ជើញប្រាប់មកខ្ញុំថាឲ្យធ្វើចាស់គុំគូរក្នុងឃុំជាមួយគ្នាហើយអាយុអាបងបងបីឆ្នាំឬប្រាំឆ្នាំទៅតាមអញ្ញាអានេះខ្ញុំទៅតាមប៉ុណ្ណឹង
Est-ce que dans le cadre de cette procédure, vous vous assuriez à un moment ou à un autre que les époux donnaient, les futurs époux donné leur accord ou c'était simplement le jour de la cérémonie que vous attendiez d'avoir cet accord? Je pense qu'il y a peut-être eu un problème dans l'interprétation de ma question. Je vais la formuler autrement. Est-ce que vous avez évoqué le déroulement de la cérémonie en indiquant que Pon avait indiqué aux futurs époux que s'il y avait des gens qui ne voulaient pas se marier, ils pouvaient le dire et partir. Ma question est de savoir, est-ce qu'à un autre moment que le jour de la cérémonie, que chef adjoint du comité de district, est-ce que vous avez pris des mesures particulières pour savoir est-ce que les futurs époux étaient d'accord ou pas? Ou est-ce que c'était du ressort des chefs des unités mobiles ou est-ce que c'était simplement le jour de la cérémonie? D'accord, donc ma question était de savoir, est-ce que c'est donc vous, je comprends votre réponse plutôt, que c'est seulement le jour de la cérémonie que la question de l'accord se posait. Vous, en tant que chef adjoint du district, vous ne preniez pas les informations préalables avant le jour de la cérémonie. Est-ce que je dois comprendre ça de votre réponse?
นี่ถ้าอดตั้งดังเตอ้อทางเครียงทางกองทางใสทางพระนั่งดังไงนั้นแน่ทางพระเมย์เมย์นั้นคือเฮาเจ้าทางใสนั้นเมย์เมย์ทางนี้เฮาโยมอเหตุการณ์เตมันดังอดเครียงมองนั่นนี่ก็ยุ่งเฉลยจำนวนนั้น
Donc, je vais être sûr de bien comprendre, vous-même, vous n'entriez pas en contact, vous preniez la décision, mais vous n'avez pas pris de mesures particulières pour informer les gens avant la cérémonie, ni recueillir leur accord. Ça ne faisait pas partie du travail que vous
effectuez.
Je n'ai pas entendu de réponse à ma question. J'ai cru entendre bas en Khmer. Nous n'avons pas eu la traduction française, excusez-moi. Je voudrais revenir très brièvement sur un passage de votre déclaration. C'est des cams que vous avez lu, monsieur le procureur, hier. Je vais vous la relire pour que vous l'ayez bien à l'esprit, sachant que la question que je vais vous poser est bien sûr différente de celle de l'accusation. Et je fais référence, monsieur le Président, au document E3-5643, à l'URN en français 00756607, à l'URN en anglais 00753864, et à l'URN en Khmer 00059360, et ça se poursuit sur la page suivante, et en français aussi ça se poursuit sur la page suivante. Donc on vous pose des questions sur si des rapports étaient envoyés à la hiérarchie, et vous dites il n'y avait pas de rapport, aucun rapport. Et la question suivante, je vous ai posé la suivante: est-ce que ça n'allait pas jusqu'au comité central? Votre réponse: non, cela n'allait même pas jusqu'à l'échelon de la commune. Ces gens étaient perfides. Quand ils détestaient quelqu'un, quand ils étaient en colère contre quelqu'un, quand ils nourrissaient une rancune contre quelqu'un, ils se mettaient alors à altérer la vérité. Il y avait bien une société, mais la loi, elle n'existait que sur le papier. C'était l'anarchie la plus totale. Tout dépendait des individus qui avait du pouvoir, à savoir les chefs de village et les chefs de commune. Ils pouvaient faire ce qu'ils voulaient. Personne ne les surveillait. Personne ne les contrôlait. Ils n'hésitaient pas à faire des rapports pour justifier de pouvoir tuer telle ou telle personne en les accusant d'être des ennemis, d'être ceci ou cela. Fin de citation. Lorsque, monsieur le coprocureur, vous avez posé des questions à ce sujet. Vous avez indiqué que vous avez parlé en fonction de ce que vous avez vécu et de votre expérience. Donc ma question est de savoir, est-ce que, par exemple, dans le district de Soeun, où vous avez été chef adjoint du comité de district, vous avez eu des exemples de chefs de village, de chefs de commune qui ont altéré la vérité et ont commis des abus de pouvoir en accusant à tort des personnes d'être des ennemis? Et si vous vous en souvenez, est-ce que vous vous souvenez des villages et des communes en question? Vous dites n'avoir pas connu de tel incident, alors pourquoi, lorsque vous avez été interrogé par le DCCAM, vous avez tenu ces propos, et sur quel fondement est-ce que vous avez tenu ces propos?
Ca nghiên nó về tôi chỉ tu từ rồi không mà rồi một nằm nằm bây giờ chưa tới bên tay rồi nhìn gì to to cái
D'accord, donc quand vous dites tout le monde en parlait, est-ce que vous pouvez nous indiquer à quel moment vous en avez entendu parler? Et est-ce que vous avez des exemples au niveau du comité de district où vous avez travaillé?
Chạy lẽ của mình đăng với cái chạy lẽ của mình hiên tha rồi về ca này dây ban này cho trăm du pê của tha ban tha nhom lịch len cho của tha má này đôi gì chọc thì cái đây tầm năng đàn.
Tout à l'heure, répondant à mon confrère de l'équipe de Mouchéa, vous avez cité l'exemple de Chim en disant que vous avez fait procéder à son arrestation parce qu'il avait formé un certain nombre de fausses accusations à l'égard de personnes qui n'avaient rien fait. Est-ce que c'est un exemple d'abus de pouvoir que vous évoquiez dans votre DCCAM ou est-ce que vous pensiez également à autre chose? ហេតុមូលហេតុដែលត្រូវចាប់វានេះគេហៅថាបំភ្លៃណែចម្លើយមិនថានេះពាក្យតែប៉ុណ្ណឹងដែលត្រូវចាប់វានោះចាប់បំភ្លៃពាក្យតែប៉ុណ្ណឹងទេ
Je sais que nous arrivons à la pause. Une dernière question, Monsieur le Président. Je vous pose ces questions parce que ce n'est pas le seul passage où vous avez indiqué cela dans votre CDCAM. Il y a un autre passage que je voudrais vous faire expliquer. Donc, toujours le même document, 3/5643, ERN en français 007-56-650, ERN en anglais 00-75-3899 et URN en Khmer 00-59-4-06. La question qui vous est posée est la suivante. En parlant de CETC, mais ce tribunal ne juge que les hauts dirigeants. À votre avis, il faudrait juger seulement les hauts dirigeants ou également les gens des échelons inférieurs? Et votre réponse a été la suivante. Je voudrais qu'on juge les gens de l'échelon inférieur. Je crois que ce serait mieux. En effet, mais c'est cette partie de la phrase qui m'intéresse, c'était eux qui ont altéré et ruiné la ligne. Fin de citation. Est-ce que vous pouvez expliquer à la Chambre ce que vous entendez par « ce sont eux qui ont altéré et ruiné la ligne »
Ce sont eux qui ont altéré et ruiné la ligne.
ខ្ញុំថាបាននិយាយឬក៏បានទេរឿងពាក្យហ្នឹងដូចគេថានិយាយតតភោគប្រាយតគ្នានេះព្រោះចិននិយាយតែអញ្ចឹងអឺនៅរាជការជាតិឆ្នាំ70មកហូតដល់ឥឡូវដែលមានជីវិតរស់នៅថ្ងៃហ្នឹងខ្ញុំឃើញនិយាយតែអញ្ចឹងដែរពាក្យហ្នឹង
Vous me parlez de 1970, moi je vous parle des événements de 1975 à 1979. Est-ce que vous pouvez préciser si vous avez entendu entre 1975 et 1979 des gens dire que la ligne du parti avait été dévoyée et que ce qui avait été appliqué au niveau local n'était pas la politique qui avait été déterminée par le parti? Est-ce que vous avez entendu parler de cela?
តាលោកមានលឺគេនិយាយអញ្ចឹងទេនៅចន្លោះឆ្នាំ1975ដល់79ពាក្យហ្នឹងគឺចាប់ពីក្រោយដល់ពីមេសាមកលហូតចាប់ដល់17មេសាបានដឹងមកនៅលឺពាក្យហ្នឹង
Mon temps est écoulé, Monsieur le Président, je m'en arrêterai là, à moins que la Chambre m'autorise 5 minutes supplémentaires à la reprise de la pause déjeuner pour essayer d'obtenir plus de clarifications. Je vous remercie. Monsieur la partie vous venez d'indiquer en français, j'ai entendu qu'après le 17 avril 1975, vous avez entendu d'autres mots. Cette réponse n'est pas très claire, en tout cas en français. Est-ce que vous pourriez préciser ma question de départ était de savoir si vous avez entendu qu'il y avait des critiques qui étaient portées et qui étaient à l'égard de personnes qui auraient mal appliqué la politique du parti, toujours en lien avec les passages de votre déclaration CDCAM que je vous ai lu tout à l'heure.
นานมาปีเนี่ยดึกน้องข้างเก่าข้างเก่ามันได้จับสำลับหน้าจะมีกรมมีภูมิอาจมีสิทธิ์สำลับกี่บ้านสมัยนั้นอาจารย์จะเลือกเลือกว่านี่ดังนั้นจำบ้านนี่ก็จะเหม็นในใจอ้อยสมัยจะเลือกเลยนะเด้อยมใจในฝ่ายในไอ้บุตรเพื่อ
C'est une drôle de présenterie, mais avec qui est-ce que vous avez ces bavardages informels? Je m'en arrêterai là, Monsieur le Président.
លោកធានលោកខ្ញុំសួរចាប់ហើយលោកធានសូមអរគុណលោកធានអរគុណលោកមេធាវីលោកសេងសឿនក្នុងឋានៈលោកជាដើមម្ដងរដ្ឋបាលមនីចំពោះមុខអង្គជំរះនេះលោកអាចថ្លែងរៀបរាប់ប្រាប់ដល់អង្គសាវនាការស្ដាប់អំពីរឿងហើយតំណាក់តំណងទៅនឹងបទក្រិតដែលត្រូវបានចោទប្រកាន់ទៅលើជនជាប់ចោទទាំងពីររូបលោកនួនជានិងខៀវសំផនដែលបានប៉ះពាល់ចំពោះលោកនៅក្នុងម្លងរបបកម្ពុជាប្រជាធិបតេយ្យ ពីថ្ងៃទី7ខែមេសាឆ្នាំ1976រហូតដល់ថ្ងៃទី6មករាឆ្នាំ1976និងអំពីស្ថានភាពជាសនកម្មគឺការខូចខាតដែលកើតមានឡើងចំពោះលោកជាអាចការខូចខាតខាងរាងកាយសម្ភារៈឬក៏ផ្លូវចិត្តហើយជាផលប៉ះពាល់ផលវិបាកដែលផ្ទាល់ពីបទឧក្រិដ្ឋជាសនកម្មផ្ទាល់ខ្លួននិងបាតការមានឡើងពិតប្រាកដរហូតដល់បច្ចុប្បន្ននេះ ដែលនាំឲ្យលោកតាំងខ្លួនជាដើមម្ដងរដ្ឋបាលវិនីប្តឹងទាមទារសំណងនិងជាសមូហភាពពីជនជាប់ចោតបើសិនជាលោកមានបំណងដូច្នេះគឺលោកអាចថ្លែងរៀបរាប់ពីស្ថានភាពទុកសោកវេទនានិងជាសនកម្មចំពោះមុខអង្គជំនះបានឬអាចតាំងសំណួរទៅជនជាប់ចោតតាមរយៈអង្គជំនះ
Mình men ấy bên ngài thế, tại còn là sông nông bộ hàng tà lạc cá. Nhóm sông tìm điệp tha, tầm nào ơi chỉ biết bọc nhóm đưa ta trái thôi. Trăm năm chất tập ở đó bên ấy. Bầm ra chết, hốt bị ca luôn. Ai nghĩ tới bọn ôn cho đôn đôi bục mía thông ấy, kê sầm lập. Mẹ xâm lập cháu đó, người vô bộ vi nó xâm lập trong lò hả nè. Vì hút nó dây nó thả ra mấy tiết. Ai khuôn nhóm tiết,
ខ្ញុំសូមអញ្ជើញលោកមេធាវីនួនជាឡើងបន្តសំណួរសូមជួយក្រោកឈរ